Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I just filmed another video hoping that by the time I would film this one that my neighbors would stop playing loud music. They have not. So if you can hear that, I apologize, but I wanted to share a book haul. This is from Thrift Books. One of you guys recommended Thrift Books to me. I will put your name right here. But so thank you so much for recommending the website to me. I went on their app and purchased a few things, and they also had a code you could use for, I think it was 15% off. So I'm gonna put that in the description. It's not like an affiliate code or anything. It's just like I found it on their website and was just like, can get a discount on books. So I ordered 12 books because they were cheap. I got all of them for like 30 something dollars for 12 books. I mean, you can't beat that. So the first three that I bought are from a series. I got the Red Queen, the White Queen, and the Lady of the River, which I believe is the first one in this series. And I had watched the series, I think it was The White Princess. I can't remember if it was The White Queen or White Princess, but it has to do with the War of Roses, and it's called White Queen, Red Queen, because the two houses were the red roses and white roses were their symbols, so hence white and red. That's why. But yeah, she actually, this author has written a ridiculous amount of books, and I realized that I had some of hers, but I didn't have all of them, and she has a suggested list of the order to read them in, so I'm kind of going off of that to read them chronologically. So the first one I will be reading is this one, but plan on going through this series. I love historical fiction, and yeah, this just interests me. So I bought the first three. Another series that I decided to get was the Mortal Instruments. I got the first two, City of Bones and City of Ashes. I mentioned in a recent video that this is a popular series that I have never read, and I don't know why. So decided to go ahead and purchase the first two. I think this is a series that I will really like. And I think my husband will also like this. It's kind of always a bonus when we can both read something and then discuss it afterwards, because he really likes fantasy. So definitely excited to read these as well. I feel like I'm giving myself so many series to read, but it's fine. The next one is Pretty Little Secrets, and this is from the Pretty Little Liars collection. And I also had read, it's called like Allie's Little Secrets or something. There's a few other books besides the main series. And I think this is the last of them that I haven't read. I know this author also wrote The Perfectionist, which I just heard is going to be a series now on Freeform. I always want to say ABC Family. It's called Freeform now. And apparently Allie and Mona are going to be in it. And I don't know how to feel about it yet, but wanted to go ahead and read this. Whether or not I'll read The Perfectionist, I don't know. I have actually have no idea what it's about, so I'm going to tell you. And the next one is called The Morning Bells, and I actually can't see who it's by because there is a sticker. Christine something. I'm obviously going to find it and put it down below. This was a book I had on Amazon that I really wanted to read. That's kind of what I did for these, is I looked through my Amazon wish list and then looked on Thrift Books and just kind of purchased ones that were a heck of a lot cheaper. And this one says, one of Victoria London's most respectful undertakers, Violet Harper, has the new duty of accompanying coffins from various undertakers on the London Railway for respectful funerals and burials in Surrey? Oh, people in England are probably gonna hate me for that. Sorry. Inside the coffin, Violet finds a man wide-eyed with fear, claiming he was falsely interred. So I think this looks really interesting. It looks like a mystery, and I believe this is a series as well, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, they looked really interesting, especially for Halloween season. This next one is The Grown Up by Gillian Flynn, and this is the same author who wrote Gone Girl, Sharp Objects, and I'm trying to remember the name of the other book without looking. Dark Places is the other one. I have them immediately behind me. She's one of my favorite authors, and this is a shorter book. It's only, I think, 60 pages. So I feel like I'm gonna get through this really quickly, but she's one of my favorite authors. And I didn't even know this book existed, so I saw it on there. I was just like, I want that. So the next one is The Stopped Heart, which I don't know if it came ripped or if I did that. I don't know. Which this book also takes place in England, and it says during a vicious storm, a red-headed stranger appears outside a farmer's cottage. The family takes him in, but he has no intention of leaving. And again, just sounded like a book I would enjoy. And I was kind of wanting creepier books because it's almost Halloween. The next one I got was Wicked, which I used to own this and I have no idea what happened to it. Knowing me, I probably lent it to somebody and forgot and just never got it back. But I own a few of these out of the series. I think they're immediately behind me. Are they? Yeah, right there. I have some of them and I realized I didn't have Wicked and I was like, why? Why do I not have that? Because I'm kind of wanting to reread that series at some point. Or not reread it. The only one I've read is the first one. So actually read the series at some point. So went ahead and picked that up. The next one I got because I saw Emma Books talk about it, and it is The Bone Season. And I don't even remember what this was about, to be honest. I just remember her talking about it and it just looked so good. It says, for Paige is a dreamwalker, a rare kind of clairvoyant, and under Scion law, she commits treason simply by breathing. Yeah, and I believe this is a trilogy as well. I saw Emma Books talk about it and it looked really interesting. And again, it looked like something my husband would like as well, so wanted to pick it up. The very last one I have is We Could Be Beautiful. And I love this cover right now. But this is one that I had saved on Amazon as well. And so it's about a girl who lives in Manhattan, is very privileged, lives on the Upper East Side, which just reminds me of Gossip Girl. I love the way that this is described. Featuring a fascinating heroine who longs for answers but is blinded by her own privilege, We Could Be Beautiful is a glittering, seductive, surprising story of love, money, greed, and family. So just looked interesting. I don't know if I'm gonna love this, hate it, I don't know, but I don't even remember where I heard about this from, but. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys liked this haul. I will probably be purchasing from thrift books more in the future. Probably shouldn't do that anytime soon because I have way too many books to read, if that's even a thing. I hope you guys did like this video. Thank you so much for watching. And if you did like this video, please be sure to like and subscribe and hit the bell and all of that jazz. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram. My links are in the thingamajigger, and I will see you later. Bye.